हेलो एवरीवन एंड वेलकम ऑल ऑफ यू. आई एम जाधव अनिता, वर्किंग एज अ असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन फिजिक्स एट मराठा विद्या प्रसारक समाज नाशिक. इन दिस लेक्चर आई विल गोइंग टू डिस्कस हियर अ फर्स्ट चैप्टर ऑफ एटॉमिक स्ट्रक्चर इन विच न्यू टॉपिक वेक्टर एटम मॉडल एंड क्वांटम नंबर्स. वेक्टर एटम मॉडल. इन अ लास्ट लेक्चर we had already explained a Bohr-Sommerfeld theory. In which Bohr-Sommerfeld theory, I will introduce the three quantum numbers n, k, and r, where n represents the principal quantum numbers, k will be the azimuthal quantum numbers, and r is the radial quantum numbers. Now, this vector atom model are used to overcome all these drawbacks of this Bohr-Sommerfeld theory. In which Bohr-Sommerfeld theory, to overcome all these drawbacks of this Bohr-Sommerfeld theory, a new model was invented called as vector atom model. Now, the first drawback of this Bohr-Sommerfeld theory, the Bohr theory could not explain the details of fine structure of an spectral lines of an hydrogen atom. The vector atom models, you know that the hydrogen having atomic number z is equal to 1, the vector atom model are used to explain the concept of one or many electron. Bohr theory could not explain the fine structure for one electron only. Then, application of a theory of relativity and the concept of an elliptical orbit by Sommerfeld to the Bohr theory helped to find the fine structure of an spectral lines. Bohr-Sommerfeld model could not explain a new discoveries like Zeeman effect and Stark effect. Zeeman was the scientist and it would be explained how was the splitting of spectral lines in various shells or subshells. Means how was the spectral lines are split in various shells or subshells, that could be explained by the Zeeman. Now, therefore, in order to overcome all these drawbacks of this Bohr-Sommerfeld theory, the new model was invented called as vector atom model. In a vector atom model, the two distinct features of this vector atom model, first is the space quantization and another one is the spinning of an electron, or it is also called as the electron spin. Or special quantization, it is also called as the space quantization. The space quantization, the quantization of direction of L bar with respect to the external magnetic field H bar is called as the space quantization. The space quantization means the electron orbits are quantized in space. You know what is meant by the quantized, or what is meant by quantization? The word quantization, you will be know. What is meant by quantization? Sometimes we will say that the energy is quantized, momentum is quantized, whatever. Quantized means what? Quantization or quantized means that, suppose these are the electron orbits, n is equal to 1, 2 and 3 are the electron orbits. And in the last lecture, we had already explained the energy of an orbit will be different for different orbits. Means n is equal to 1, 2 and 3. The having energy is suppose E1, E2 and E3 respectively. Then quantized means what? The energy is different for different orbits, but the energy difference is same. Means E2 minus E1, E3 minus E2 or E4 minus E3 will become same. That is called as the quantization. Means I will here this value are, this energy difference is same. Then I will say that the energy is quantized in space, called as the quantization. Okay. In a vector atom model, quantum numbers n, k and m given by Bohr-Sommerfeld theory are replaced by a new quantum number NLML as per the quantum mechanics. These are the N, K and M represents the principal quantum number, azimuthal quantum number and radial quantum numbers. Then N, L or ML, N represents the principal quantum numbers and having values is 1, 2, 3, 2 up to infinity. Then L is the orbital quantum numbers and having values is 0, 1, 2, 3, 2 up to N minus 1. And ML is the orbital magnetic quantum number and having value is minus L to plus L. According to quantum mechanics, the total angular momentum of an electron is given by, angular momentum is a vector quantity and is given by L bar is equal to square root of L into L plus 1 into H upon 2 pi, where H is the Planck's constant and the small l is the orbital quantum number. Now, the projection of L bar on the direction of an magnetic field H bar along the Z axis has magnitudes which are given by Lz is equal to ML into H upon 2 pi, where ML is the magnetic quantum number. Now, the space quantization of the orbital angular momentum for a L is equal to 2 or 3 is given that there is a diagram of L is equal to 2 or L is equal to 3 of an electron for the space quantization. Now, in a L is equal to 2, now we have to calculate here first is the number of orientations in L bar in a space R. How we have to calculate the number of orientations? The formula is that 2L plus 1. L having value is 2, then 2L plus 1 is equal to 2 into 1 plus 1 is equal to 5. And having magnitude, how was the calculate? Magnitude of L bar, L star is equal to square root of L into L plus 1 and L having value is 2, therefore L star is equal to root 6. Then in this way I will calculate the L is equal to 3, the number of orientations L bar in space R, means number of orientations for L is equal to 3 is 2 into 3 plus 1 is equal to 7. 2 into 3 plus 1 is equal to 7 and the magnitude of L bar is equal to root 3 into 3 plus 1 is equal to root 12. Here, as shown in the figure, there is the space quantization of an orbital angular momentum for L is equal to 2 and L is equal to 3 electrons. In the first figure, here I will see here the magnetic field is along the Z axis, will be the ML having values from plus 2 to minus 2, means the number of orientations of L bar in a space are for L is equal to 2 electrons, then 2L plus 1 is equal to 5, here 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5, means the number of orientations will be 5 for L is equal to 2 electrons. Then for L is equal to 3, the number of orientations will be 7. In this way, we have to calculate the L is equal to 4, the number of orientations will be 9. For L is equal to 5, the number of orientations will be 11. Okay. Now, in the next features of a vector atomic model is the electron spin. According to the quantum theory, the spin of the electron should be quantized, means I have only say that the momentum or energy is quantized, but the quantum theory says that the spin of the electron is also quantized. Hence, a new quantum number is introduced called as the spin quantum number. Okay. According to the idea of a space quantization, orbital as well as spin motion both are quantized in magnitude and direction. According to the old theories, electron has supposed to have only orbital motion. Hence, ओनली ऑर्बिटल एंगुलर मोमेंटम एंड ऑर्बिटल मैग्नेटिक मोमेंट आर कंसिडर्ड. ओके, द इलेक्ट्रॉन हैव ओनली द ऑर्बिटल मोशन, देन वी हैव टू कंसिडर ओनली द ऑर्बिटल एंगुलर मोमेंटम एंड ऑर्बिटल मैग्नेटिक मोमेंट ऑफ एन इलेक्ट्रॉन. बट इलेक्ट्रॉन हैज स्पिनिंग मोशन, देयरफॉर वी हैव टू कंसिडर द स्पिन मोशन ऑफ एन इलेक्ट्रॉन ऑल्सो और द स्पिन मैग्नेटिक मोमेंट. नाउ द स्पिन एंगुलर मोमेंटम एस बार इज गिवन बाय एस बार इज इक्वल टू स्क्वेयर रूट ऑफ एस इंटू एस प्लस वन इंटू एच अपॉन टू पाय. द वैल्यू ऑफ एच अपॉन टू पाय इज ऑल्सो राइट द एच कट, वेयर एस इज द स्पिन क्वांटम नंबर एंड इट्स वैल्यू इज एस इज इक्वल टू प्लस और माइनस वन हाफ. एम एस इज इक्वल टू प्लस वन हाफ रिप्रेजेंट द स्पिन अप स्टेट एंड एम एस इज इक्वल टू माइनस वन हाफ रिप्रेजेंट द स्पिन डाउन स्टेट. क्वांटम नंबर्स, वॉट इज मीन बाय क्वांटम नंबर्स? द क्वांटम नंबर्स आर यूज टू डिटरमाइन द कंप्लीट क्वांटम स्टेट ऑफ एन इलेक्ट्रॉन्स, मीन्स टू डिस्क्राइब द कंप्लीट क्वांटम स्टेट ऑफ एन इलेक्ट्रॉन्स इन विच वेरियस पैरामीटर्स आर यूज. दिस सेट्स ऑफ पैरामीटर्स कॉल्ड एज द क्वांटम नंबर्स, मीन्स दिस पैरामीटर्स इन विच लाइक साइज ऑफ द ऑर्बिट, साइज एनर्जी और शेप ऑफ द ऑर्बिट, दिस सेट्स ऑफ पैरामीटर्स कॉल्ड एज द क्वांटम नंबर्स. नाउ द डिस्क्रीट नेचर ऑफ एन एनर्जी स्टेट इज द नेचुरल आउटकम ऑफ दिस श्रोडिंगर इक्वेशन विच इज कैरेक्टराइज बाय थ्री क्वांटम नंबर्स. दे आर प्रिंसिपल क्वांटम नंबर एन, सेकेंड इज द ऑर्बिटल क्वांटम नंबर एल, नेक्स्ट इज द ऑर्बिटल मैग्नेटिक क्वांटम नंबर एम एल एंड लास्ट वन इज द स्पिन मैग्नेटिक क्वांटम नंबर एम एस. आई विल इंट्रोड्यूस वन बाय वन हियर. फर्स्ट इज द प्रिंसिपल क्वांटम नंबर एन, द नेम इज दैट प्रिंसिपल क्वांटम नंबर. ओके, द प्रिंसिपल क्वांटम नंबर एन स्पेसिफाइज द ऑर्बिट नंबर, साइज ऑफ द ऑर्बिट एंड द एनर्जी स्टेट ऑफ एन ऑर्बिट. ओके, प्रिंसिपल क्वांटम नंबर्स आर यूज टू डिटरमाइन द साइज और एनर्जी ऑफ एन ऑर्बिट. इन अ लास्ट वीडियो वी हैड ऑलरेडी लर्न दिस इक्वेशन, द रेडियस ऑफ एन एंथ ऑर्बिट एंड द एनर्जी ऑफ एन इलेक्ट्रॉन इन द एंथ ऑर्बिट. द रेडियस ऑफ एन एंथ ऑर्बिट विल बी एप्सिलॉन जीरो एन स्क्वेयर एच स्क्वेयर अपॉन पाई एम ई स्क्वेयर एंड एनर्जी ऑफ एन इलेक्ट्रॉन इन द एंथ ऑर्बिट इज माइनस एम ई रेस टू फोर अपॉन एट एप्सिलॉन जीरो स्क्वेयर एन स्क्वेयर एच स्क्वेयर, वेयर ई एन इज द टोटल एनर्जी ऑफ एन इलेक्ट्रॉन इन द एंथ ऑर्बिट. फ्रॉम दिस टू इक्वेशंस वी हैव टू से दैट द रेडियस ऑफ एन इलेक्ट्रॉन इन द एंथ ऑर्बिट इज डायरेक्टली प्रोपोर्शनल टू स्क्वेयर ऑफ प्रिंसिपल क्वांटम नंबर एंड ई एन इज इनवर्सली प्रोपोर्शनल टू एन स्क्वेयर. फ्रॉम दिस इक्वेशन द एन इज द प्रिंसिपल क्वांटम नंबर एंड हैविंग वैल्यूज इज वन टू थ्री फोर एंड सो ऑन, मीन्स विच रिप्रेजेंट एन इज इक्वल टू वन टू थ्री रिप्रेजेंट द शेल्स, मीन्स एन इज इक्वल टू वन रिप्रेजेंट द के शेल, एन इज इक्वल टू टू रिप्रेजेंट द एल शेल एंड सो ऑन, मीन्स द टोटल नंबर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन्स इन अ शेल आर टू एन स्क्वेयर. द टू एन स्क्वेयर मीन्स फॉर अ के शेल, फॉर द एन हैविंग वैल्यूज इज वन मीन्स के शेल हैविंग अ टू इलेक्ट्रॉन्स, एल हैविंग अ एट इलेक्ट्रॉन्स एंड एम शेल हैविंग अ 18 इलेक्ट्रॉन्स एंड सो ऑन. फ्रॉम दिस फॉर्मूला वी हैव टू कैलकुलेट द इलेक्ट्रॉन्स इन वेरियस शेल्स. ओके, द नेक्स्ट क्वांटम नंबर इज द ऑर्बिटल क्वांटम नंबर, इट रिप्रेजेंट्स द स्मॉल लेटर एल. ओके, दिस क्वांटम नंबर्स आर यूज टू डिटरमाइन द शेप ऑफ एन ऑर्बिट, मीन्स हाउ वॉज द शेप ऑफ एन ऑर्बिट, द स्फेरिकल डम्बेल और ए डबल डम्बेल. ओके, दिस क्वांटम नंबर arises due to the orbital motion of an electron orbit. This gives rise to the orbital angular momentum of an electron. On the basis of an classical mechanics, we have to know the concept of an angular momentum or a orbital angular momentum. In the last video, I had explained that the whatever the any space is having mass m and along the tangents its velocity is v, then we say that the angular momentum is L is equal to m into v into r, where m is the mass of the electron, v is the velocity and r is the radius vector. L is the perpendicular to the plane of an electron in an orbit. According to the Bohr's second postulate, is that the angular momentum having values only the integral multiple of h upon 2 pi, means where n is n having values is 1, 2, 3 and so on, means never the value of an angular momentum is 0.5 h by 2 pi, 2.5 h by 2 pi. The angular momentum having value only the 1h upon 2 pi, 2h upon 2 pi and so on. Okay. According to the quantum mechanics, the orbital angular momentum of an electron takes the discrete values as L is equal to square root of L into L plus 1 into h upon 2 pi, where L is the orbital angular momentum quantum number, and having restricted values L is equal to 0, 1, 2, 3 up to n minus 1, where n is the principal quantum number. Next is the orbital magnetic quantum number ML. If the atom is placed in weak magnetic field H bar, then the orbital angular momentum L bar of an electron interacts with the applied magnetic field, and these applied magnetic field are the quantization to the direction of L bar takes place in discrete manner. The component of L along the direction of external magnetic field along the z axis is given by Lz is equal to ML into H upon 2 pi, where ML is called as the orbital magnetic quantum number and having value is ML is equal to minus L to plus L. The next quantum number called as the spin magnetic quantum number MS. The spin magnetic quantum number, you know that the electron have two spin, the spin up or a spin down. The spin magnetic quantum number MS is due to the electron spin, which is considered to the intrinsic property of an electron. The spin angular momentum of an electron is given by equation S is equal to square root of S into S plus 1 into H upon 2 pi, where S is the spin quantum number and having values is plus or minus 1 half. MS is the spin magnetic quantum number. It has only two possible values. MS is equal to plus 1 half represents to spin up state, and MS is equal to minus 1 half correspond to spin down state. Okay. Now, here I will introduce the new concept, total angular momentum, which is represents the capital letter J. What is meant by total angular momentum? Total angular momentum is that the sum of orbital angular momentum and spin angular momentum, and it is numerically calculated as J bar is equal to L bar plus or minus S bar. For S is equal to 1 half, therefore J is equal to L is equal to plus or minus 1 half, because S having a only two values, plus or minus 1 half, therefore I will write here the total angular momentum. Now, according to quantum mechanics, the total angular momentum of an electron is given by J bar is equal to square root of J into J plus 1 into H upon 2 pi, where J is the total angular momentum of an electron. Okay? Thank you.